guys, what's up, girlfriends, films, fans? I'm Samantha Ryan, and this is the Kinky and Creepy Show, and I'm here with my partner in crime, Miss Dana D'Armand. Thank you.
Thank you. Both kinky and creepy.
Yes.
And our special guest.
Yes, we have
this episode.
Yes, Dr. Chantel Tibbles.
Hello.
Thank you so much for being here.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do?
Well, I'm a sociologist, and I study the adult industry, and I've been studying the industry for about 10 years now, and I look at all aspects of production and performers and different sort of issues shaping the industry. I kind of keep one foot in the mainstream and one foot in the industry.
You're right there.
Right in the middle. Where all of this, like, Dungeons and Dragons and hell and torture
yeah,
and
very
manipulation.
That's serendipitous.
Yeah, it was.
That you just happened to be, like, right in the epicenter of porn hell.
Yeah. Yes, porn hell. And that's what I was reading about.
Making sure that it actually works, it puts those names in. Every domain name that goes through is ICANN is responsible to make sure that that happens. There are registries, which are like ICM, which own the .xxx, .mobi, .net. And those are registries that are responsible for putting that out. And then there are registrars like a GoDaddy that sell those for them. So that we'll be talking about registries and registrars tonight. .xxx was premised on protecting children, but what we really know is that it was a business move on ICM's part. And that's fine. I mean, I have no problem with people making industry. The problem that I have with this is they're doing that on the backs of the folks from the adult entertainment industry at a time when our industry is actually really tight.
This is an accident. This is a happy accident. So the subscriptions started to come in, and instead of it being guys, it was like Joe's Video, Omaha, Nebraska, Video Village, Phoenix, Arizona, all these little mom and pop video stores that were popping up that were desperate for information on porn because they didn't know either. And that is how it happened.
You have many interests outside of making the pornos.
I do.
Like?
I do.
Your?
Dogs!
Yes, I know. And actually even like the girlfriend's movie Strays, Celeste Starr is holding my little dog, Mia. Mm. On the cover of Strays, and we did a PSA for that movie as well. And some of the people that were in the PSA are actually adopters of dogs that they got from me, which is kind of cool. So, yeah, that's been really, really nice.
Like, we would have like 90-page scripts, right? So you'd end up getting maybe like 15 minutes of setup for a 5-minute sex scene. Mm-hmm. Where now we're lucky if we get 5 minutes of setup for a 15-minute sex scene. So it's just kind of like backwards. And they used to not pay per sex scene. You know, they would pay you whatever you're making. Like I think back then, I started out at $300 a day, I think. And then I went up to, I think I was making $600. And they said, oh, well, for $600, you're gonna have to do blah, 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 blah. And I think I got up until about $1,000. That's back then.
Huh.
That's so good money, I think, though.
It was really great money. I was working for, like, Psychology Today and making, like, $125 for the week. Mm.